We're about to talk about a property. Well, when I say scam, it's about leaseholds and a nightmare faced by hundreds of householders in Greater Manchester. The government's coming under pressure to do more to help householders caught up in a scandal involving new build homes which are sold as leasehold with ground rents that double every 10 years.
Well, BBC Radio Manchester has learned that there are hundreds of people in Greater Manchester who've been caught up by the small print. It's one of the main areas where developers have been selling every new property as leasehold.
We'll hear from one of the householders in just a mo, but first here's Matt Trewin with more details on what's been happening on some new estates.
Leasehold properties have been around for hundreds of years. It means you don't own the land your property is built on, and you'll pay an annual ground rent to someone who does. In older properties, you'll probably be asked to pay a peppercorn rent, just a few pounds a year. But it's now come to light that tens of thousands of new build properties have been sold with leasehold contracts that double every decade over the next 50 years. That could see some householders eventually paying out £10,000 a year, every year, in ground rent. So could the solution be buying your freehold? Well, despite being told by developers they could purchase them for a few thousand pounds, many buyers find they've already been sold on and now cost anything up to £50,000. And selling up is not an option. Estate agents have taken properties off the market once a solicitor flags up the problem, telling householders they are worthless.
Well, almost 3 years ago, Adam Fletcher moved into a brand new three-bed Taylor Wimpey property in Blakely. He's been speaking to BBC Radio Manchester's Jacqueline Payne about what happened to him.
The quality of that, the build, you can't really argue with it. I'm quite happy with it. I spent the first 2 years here really happy with it.
Adam Fletcher was a first-time buyer when he bought this three-bedroomed house on the Miller's Brow development in Blakely.
I bought this house originally because it seemed like a really good deal. The price was a lot cheaper from where I lived originally in Sandbach in Cheshire. So I bought the house in 2014, brand new off Taylor Wimpey. I bought it in the summer and moved in the October.
That decking, did you put the decking down?
I did put the decking down.
So everything out here you've done, have you?
Yeah. There's some wild roses.
So you knew the property was on sale as a leasehold property?
Yes. My brother recently bought a house on the estate, had been offered to buy the freehold, and he put his money on his mortgage. When I asked to do the same, I was told that for my benefit, it would be better for me to not buy the freehold because that would put the price of my property up £5,500. So in order to save me on paying stamp duty, I would buy the house leasehold and then I would buy the freehold within 2 weeks of moving in.
But Adam struggled to pin down Taylor Wimpey on buying that freehold, and 2 years after moving in, he received a letter informing him it had already been sold on. And there was another shock. Adam's ground rent is currently £295 a year, but he discovered it wouldn't stay at that amount for long.
What we weren't told by the salespeople is that that would double every 10 years. We were advised that by the solicitors in writing, but we never had the consequences of that explained to us.
So you're paying £295 a year at the moment?
Yeah.
So it'll go up next year, it actually goes up, doesn't it?
The 10 years is up on the 1st of January 2018. So the next lot of ground rent we pay will be just under £600. And then it'll be just under £1,200 and so on. I put my house up for sale and then the estate agent took it down because the house was not sellable. Another lady on the estate had the sale of her house fall through. The buyer's solicitors had told them not to buy because of the ground rent review terms. I mean, personally, it is frightening and you do feel trapped.
Adam and other residents on the estate have been left reeling by the doubling of ground rents every decade. But trying to get out of the problem by buying the freehold is prohibitively expensive. The company involved has told them they should each expect to pay anything between £40,000 and £50,000. But Adam says it's not just the residents that should be concerned.
You bought this property, like a lot of people, I imagine, here with the government's Help to Buy scheme, which is where they contributed some money to help you pay for this house so you could afford to move in. Do you think your house is worthless? If it is, what happens now?
The majority of people on this estate use the government's Help to Buy, so they pay 20% towards your house. You don't just pay them back when you move out the amount they give you, you pay them back 20% of the house. When I had my house valued, when we didn't know there was a problem, and it was worth £150,000, that's a £25,000 profit, of which the government would have 20% of. So it's £5,000-£7,000 off every house. It's a loss which the government is going to make unless they do something about it.
Taylor Wimpey didn't want to speak to us, but sent us a statement saying they recognise the concerns. And then, quite astonishingly, also said that they believe that the most effective solution, listen to this, is for customers to convert their leases to an alternative structure which addresses issues of affordability. Well, perhaps some may be more surprised that they would sell their houses with this structure then, before they themselves have sorted it. Listening to that is Sebastian O'Kelly from something called the Leasehold Knowledge Partnership, essentially an organisation that helps people who are caught up in leasehold problems. I mean, listening to Taylor Wimpey saying that they believe the most effective solution is for customers to convert their leases to an alternative structure, it wouldn't be easy the first way around to actually sell on the houses that didn't have leasehold in the first place, Sebastian.
Well, you're absolutely right. I mean, it's an absolute disgrace that Taylor Wimpey has been selling these houses as leasehold, and that other developers have been doing so too. Taylor Wimpey says it's put aside £130 million to put right the wrong that it's done to its former customers, but the Nationwide and ourselves, and we're a registered charity, by the way, and the secretariat of the all-party parliamentary group looking into this, think that 100,000 homes are blighted because of these outrageous leasehold terms.
Taylor Wimpey, as you say, not the only one, but people might be surprised to hear that new homes are still being built with leasehold, because you might be expected to come across it in very old places, say villages in the Lake District or places down in London where land is massively expensive and never seems to change hands, just the properties on it. But for new developments to have leasehold is quite a surprise to some.
It is. The justification here has been the North West has a lot of leasehold houses. I mean, three quarters of the housing stock in Bolton, for example, is leasehold from historic times, you know, and therefore new houses, customers are used to it, and therefore the North West can get loads more leasehold houses.
Three quarters in Bolton, Sebastian, that's huge.
It is, and it's really dates from sort of factory era. But there's a huge difference between, you know, your gran owning a leasehold house and paying £3 a year ground rent and buying one at £295 a year that doubles every 10 years. Basically, this is a leasehold is a tenancy. What the house builders have been doing is creating an investment asset, the freehold, at the expense of their customers, which they then sell on to anonymous murky investors who hide behind nominee directors. It's a way for anonymous investors to hitch a ride on the property market, and it really should be stopped.
What are the consequences of buying a home on leasehold, as well as the ground rent, which may double, which we'll explore more in a moment? Does it have any other impact on owning a home that's leasehold?
It most certainly does. There's a whole load of consent fees for things like keeping a pet, keeping a van on the drive, moving a wall inside the house. The house and the land are not your property. You are a tenant. That is what leasehold means. And you're very vulnerable in any litigation with the freeholder because he is the landlord. You are simply the tenant. So you're always in this position of weakness. My advice to anybody faced with buying a leasehold house is just don't do it. Insist on the freehold straight away or walk away. The other thing is, of course, that quite a few of these managed estates do have management charges, often because the council doesn't want to take pay for the roads and the pavements and things. So there are some management fees here, and we're trying to sort those out.
Gosh, it sounds like a minefield, except that when Adam was explaining the problems with him and his first 10-year lease thing is up next year, which will double his ground rent to just under 600, when you think, well, it's going to be 2028 before that doubles to £1,200. By then, though, even if that was still in force, Sebastian, £1,200 in the year 2028 might not be that off-putting, might it?
Well, it will be off-putting. I mean, what has been created at Adam's expense is a revenue stream paying about 8%. So the house that he purchased is, I think, very unlikely to be worth anything like the original the original purchase price. This is why the government has launched a consultation which closes tomorrow night at 11 o'clock. There's the community secretary, Sajid Javid, organising this. He and the Prime Minister have both said that these leasehold houses are disgraceful and must end, and anybody who owns a leasehold house or indeed a leasehold property should take part in this government consultation. The details are on our website.
That ends tomorrow night?
It does.
So people have got a chance to put forward their views. Is that any leasehold or just modern houses?
No, any leaseholder, because quite a lot of these onerous ground rent terms apply to flats, in fact. So although houses have caught the public imagination because nobody can see the point of a leasehold house, there are many people who've been sold leasehold houses, leasehold flats rather, with very onerous ground rent terms.
So if anyone listening now, Sebastian, is thinking, gosh, that includes me, what should they do if they've got concerns about a leasehold?
Well, first of all, they should fill in this, make their views felt by filling in this government survey, which closes tomorrow, because the government is going to act on this. There is going to be legislative action to put right these wrongs. The house builders have really been getting away with murder. I mean, how on earth Taylor Wimpey can refuse to say how many people have been affected, refuse to say where these leasehold properties are, which are now unsellable, is beyond belief. This has got to stop, and they've got to come clean about it. And the MPs are now calling for Taylor Wimpey to be summoned before the community's select committee and given the Philip Green treatment.
Okay, so leaseholdknowledge.com, you can find that government consultation questionnaire then, can you?
You can, yes.
All right. Thank you very much for coming on to speak to us, Sebastian O'Kelly there, leaseholdknowledge.com. Taylor Wimpey did send us a statement. I said what they said before. They recognise the concerns and trying to work something out. But if you are involved, then do go on that website. You can fill out some details and also let us know.